Serrated knives I divide into two categories. First of all, you have the cheap serrated knives, which are intended to be thrown away. They're advertised as do not need to be sharpened lifetime knives. And there's really not much we can do with these, but people do bring them to us. And my advice on these is to take one pass on the bevel on the back side of the knife, leaving the front side with its same appearance, because each of these knives has a peculiar serration pattern to it, a combination of large and small that we cannot duplicate. Then once we've taken one pass on the back side and generated a burr, we will deburr it using the Spyderco sharp maker. I usually set it up so that the triangular point of one of these rods is on the side of the serrations and the flat side of another rod is on the back side. So I can bring my knife down like this, letting it travel in and out of each serration, and then on the back side come down flat like this. This knife is built the other way around, so I would need a point on this side and a flat on this side. So. For our better serrated knives, we're going to find fairly evenly spaced semicircular scallops like this, or like this. And that's true even down to our finer scallops, which run about 1/8 inch on our tomato knife and our sausage knife. I sharpen these the same way. I set up a point for the serration on the right side and a flat on the left side, and simply bring the knife down along the serrations, letting it travel in and out of each serration as we go along. And then I'm going to sharpen the back with the flat side, laying the knife almost flat and raising it just enough that I don't scratch the back of the knife. The phenomena that we were looking at before, where we had a knife that had a low spot just ahead of the bolster, is caused by any knife sharpener where we hold the knife by the handle, because we can put more pressure here than we can out here. Yet on these serrated bread knives, most of the work is being done out here, and this is the part of the blade that's dullest. So I recommend when we're sharpening these knives that we choke up on them like this, sharpen the last couple of inches, move back a little bit, sharpen a bit more, about 4 inches, then we sharpen the major 8 inches, and then finally the full length of the knife, and then we can deburr on the back. With a little knife like this, we would only have to choke up maybe once and do the full length. But this technique will allow us to sharpen a serrated knife that is not too dull. If it's really, really dull, we need to really think about replacing it if it's cheap, or re-serrating it if it's a good knife. There is one line of serrated knives on the market that I don't sharpen, and that is this Cutco. Cutco knives have these little trapezoidal serrations that consist of actually 3 separate sharpened sections. And we don't have any equipment that can do that and do it well. But the Cutco factory offers free sharpening of these blades if you send them back to them. So I tell my customers simply, send that blade back to Cutco.